Man, it is hot out and it is bright out. But that is actually very helpful for what we're going to be talking about today. Today, we're going to be talking about sunglasses for your camera. So what do I mean by that? I mean that when you're shooting video, you're locked into certain settings. Your shutter speed is locked in depending on what frame rate you're shooting at. Your aperture is probably wide open because you want that cinematic look. That's the whole reason you upgraded to a nice camera. And your ISO is probably as low as it can go. But even with all of those settings, your video is still going to be overblown. That's where these sunglasses come in. Now, when I'm talking about sunglasses for your camera, I'm not talking about actual sunglasses. I'm talking about ND filters. The reason why you want that is because it makes your image darker. Now, you might be asking, why do I want my image darker? And let me explain. This is what I look like with an ND filter, and this is what I look like without an ND filter. I don't know what the image looks like right now, but I assume I'm blown out beyond compare and the image looks almost completely white. Now I'm still not using an ND filter and I look more exposed correctly, but I've stopped down to f22, which gives me an iPhone looking video. The whole point of upgrading to a nice camera is that you get to take advantage of those wide aperture lenses. So I was shooting at f2.0, which gives me a nice blurring of the background, but now I'm at f22, which makes everything in focus and defeats the purpose of that cinematic look. So now we're back to having an ND filter on the camera. As you can see, it makes a huge difference. The background is blurred more, I'm properly exposed, and it just gives it that cinematic look. Now there are a lot of different ND filters out there, and the ones that I use, especially for video, are called variable ND filters. And what that means is that I can change how bright something is going to be right on the filter itself. I don't need to change any camera settings. And you know what? Let me just show you right now. Now having that flexibility to just change the brightness of the image with just a twist of the lens is very helpful, and it allows me to get the shots that I need quickly. It also gives me a lot more range, because if you bought a single ND filter that wasn't variable, you'd have to be switching filters all the time, which is just a huge pain. Now obviously ND filters aren't going to make these harsh shadows go away. I am shooting at the absolute worst time of the day to shoot. The harsh light, harsh shadows, and there's not much you can do about that. But we as creatives are sometimes forced into situations that we can't control, and having the tools that allow us to get the shot so that it's usable is what the most important thing is. So this is where ND filters come in so handy. They allow you to shoot in broad daylight under any circumstance, depending on how strong of a filter you get. And it just makes life so much easier knowing that your image is properly exposed. All right, guys, that's been it from me. My name's been Mark Steiner, and I will see you next time. Roll the outro.